If you are a salesperson or a marketer, today is your lucky day. We are going to talk about very cool sales and marketing automations that will help you put your time on the majors and not on the minors. Let's begin. Tip number one, scoring rules. There are lots of users that think that the scoring rules is a great fit only for big companies that's getting hundreds and hundreds of leads every day. That's partially true. I think that the scoring rules is a great fit for every person that respects his time. I prefer in my spare time to go to the beach, to read a good book, or do something nice. But for sure, I'm not planning to waste my time on leads that I know in advance that their conversion rate are very, very small. Let me give you an example. Let's assume that Bill Gates just contacted me as a new lead. Bill came to me with a lead source that is advertisement. Now, I do know that every time that I advertise on Google AdWords, for example, I'm getting about 1% conversions on those leads, which means it's pretty much, it's a shitty conversion. But on the other side, when I'm getting referrals, I will get maybe 50% conversion because those people already gained some trust and they do know what I can offer because I'm helping their friends. So in that case, probably what I want to do is whenever someone comes with a lead source that is referral, I want to give it some priority. That's the idea of the scoring rules. Let's see how it works. When you're going to Zoho CRM and you're going down below to the scoring rules, you can set up the scoring rules. Now, if I'm going back to the leads, let me just go to the tabular view. One second. In the tabular view, if I will try to look for score, you will see that I don't get any option for score. And the reason is that I never set up a scoring rules before. So let's start. I will go to the leads module, okay? And then I will click on lead fields. When I'm getting a new lead and the lead source is, let's say, friend or referral, I like to give it 10 points. So that's rule number one. I can also say when I'm sending an email to a client and he's sending me something back, I like to give him, let's say, 5 points. Now, if he clicks on the email, which means there is some intention, I will give him 2 points. When it's bouncing, I'm going to subtract 10 points. And when he's opening my email, I will give it 1 point. Okay, let's save. Now let's go back to my lead. If I will refresh the page, you will see that the new area named score just appear here. Now I will go to Bill Gates and I will change the lead source, and whenever I change the lead source, you can see that I just got 10 points for Bill. And whenever I will send an email to Bill and he will click on it or will respond to it, then his score will go up more and more and more. The more engagement I will have with Bill, the score will go up, and based on the score, I will know which leads are going to get my attention and which leads will not get my attention. Next, we are going to talk about the lead assignment rules. Let's assume that we're getting leads from our website, and some of the leads can be automatically assigned to specific salespeople depending on their geographic location, depending on the lead amount, depending on the amount of employees in the company, and so on and so on. If we'll go to the setup, and from setup we will go to assignment rules, we will be able to create different assignment rules. For example, in this case, if the annual revenue of the company is more than $500,000, I will assign the leads directly to Josh. Now, I can create the assignment rules based on any criteria that I want. For example, if someone is coming from Canada, for example, I can assign it directly to Jeffrey. And another option is that whenever a lead is being assigned, I can create a task to this specific user, to Jeffrey, for example, and Jeffrey will get an email that notifies him that there is a new lead waiting for him. And in parallel, it will also create a task. Next, we are going to talk about email automation. When I'm working with my clients, most of them are sending email templates just because they're supposed to send them and not because they are looking for a result. Let me give you an example. In this case, I am sending a happy birthday email to my clients on their birthday. It's very easy. You can do it by going to the workflow rules. As an example, I will go and I will create a new rule. I'm going to the contacts module. I'm going and creating a happy birthday email. I'm selecting the option daytime. I will choose date of birth. And I will say that once a year on the birthday, I want the system to activate this workflow. It will be done to every contact that his birthday is not empty. And I will send the email, contact birthday email. Okay? That's very, very easy to do. Now let's go back to our example. So in this case, I am sending a happy birthday email to my clients. The thing is, they're getting on their birthday probably 100 emails that looks exactly like this email. Now that email will not convert anything and my client will not remember me or think about me as something special because I'm not triggering any emotional response in his brain. This is very common, this email. Everybody send the same email. But if, for example, I will send an email that looks like that, let me just create a new one. On a clean email, the subject will be happy birthday, my friend. And here in plain text, A and the first name of the contact. Just wanted to drop a nice email to say happy birthday. Talk soon, Lior. That's a very casual email. It's very clean. It takes 1 minute to create it. And whenever your client will open this email, he will feel that you just sent it to him from your email or something, from your iPhone or something like that. If you want to make it a little bit better, you can write sent from my iPhone. And that gives it much more personalized feeling. You like it, huh? Very cool. It actually works. People will respond to you and will say thank you because they will think that you just sent it to them manually because you remember them. Now, if you want to be more cool, you will do it 1 day before the birthday. And you will say, I just want to be the first one to wish you a happy birthday. And that will be much, much more personal than all the others. That was the last tip. I hope you enjoyed this session. If you like it, give me thumbs up so I will know to continue and produce those kind of videos. If you didn't like it, write in the comments or talk to me directly. and I can give you more and better value in the future. Until then, have a good day.